to Four Directions of Wellness. I'm Roberta Diswood, Tool Bahana Shlin, Sisakagi Bashishin, Nakaidina Deshiche Hanahi Deshanele. The coronavirus pandemic has caused one of the most challenging public health crises of the last century. It placed an enormous burden on healthcare systems and hospitals around the world. Unfortunately, for many families, the pandemic disrupted routine child immunization services. Because of this impact, many families in the Shiprock Service Unit have fallen behind on their children's vaccine schedule. With us today to educate us about childhood immunization and the importance to catch up on your child's vaccine schedule is Alice Garnanez. Alice is the immunization coordinator for the Northern Navajo Medical Center Public Health Nursing Department and has been a nurse in the Indian Health Service for 39 years. Thank you, Alice, for being here. Go ahead and tell us about yourself.
Hi, my name is Alice Garnanez, and I came to Shiprock from Brooklyn, New York, almost 40 years ago, and worked in the hospital and have been a public health nurse here for 35 years. I have four children who are Diné. They're actually young adults, and I have one Nali who is 6 years old, and that's who I am.
Well, thank you, Alice, for being here. The Shiprock Service Unit has always had some of the best children vaccination rates in the country. With the challenges parents and families are facing during the pandemic, where are we now with childhood immunizations or vaccinations?
Before I get into numbers, I just want to say that parents, grandparents, Nullies, family and friends did a beautiful job protecting the children of the Navajo Nation during the pandemic. It began 3 years ago, and adults immediately protected the children in our communities by keeping them at home. And the services were not available because many of the services at Northern Navajo Medical Center and across the country had closed down. But now is the time to continue to protect the children, but in a different way. Now it's time to bring children in to get their childhood immunizations, and this will protect them from very serious childhood diseases, which we'll talk about shortly. And all of our clinics and pediatricians are ready to see children.
Okay, and so talking about some of the rates now, what are we looking at?
Well, prior to the pandemic, depending on how far you go back, Shiprock has reported very high immunization rates, high compared to New Mexico, high compared to the United States. We used to report up to about 90%. Right now, our percentage of children who are up to date is about 69%, which means one out of every three kids is not up to date with their immunizations. This is true across the country, but we want to work at increasing this rate.
Mm-hmm. And so as we're looking at the different age groups, what can parents do to get their children back on schedule?
There's many things that we can do. The infant and young child immunizations are low, 69%, and we want to increase them. And how you would increase them is you can find out what your child's status is. And we can do that very easily. I have a phone number and a person's name, Lorena at 368-7408 in the public health department, can talk to any parent about their status. If you don't know, is my child behind or not? You can also schedule a well child visit at Northern Navajo, 368-6525, or at your own private physician's. And you could also check with your schools. If your children are older or in school, mm-hmm. Your schools may be able to help you where to go. But you can get your children vaccinated now.
Okay, that's really good information. So let's talk about the importance of childhood vaccinations. Why do parents need to vaccinate their children and babies?
Vaccines help prevent infectious diseases that once killed and harmed many babies and children. A lot of younger people don't remember this, so they wonder, why is it important? Well, I have actually seen many of these preventable illnesses, and today we still have had outbreaks of whooping cough, pertussis, measles, things like that. So you need to get your children vaccinated because that's how your children will become immune to these illnesses. Newborns, when they're born, they have their mother's immunity, but it wanes slowly. And at about 6 weeks, they have to build up their own immunity. So we're giving them their vaccines at that time. And vaccines also wake up the immune system so that children and babies can fight off things that they might come in contact with.
Okay. And what are the diseases that the vaccines are preventing?
There's so many. but some of the ones that hepatitis A and B. Mm-hmm. In not very long ago, hepatitis A was rampant in Shiprock or on the Navajo Nation. You do not see it anymore, and it is because of vaccines. Measles, mumps, those are things that when I was younger, we had them, but they are very serious and they can be deadly. And now we have a vaccine. So measles, mumps, polio, some very severe diarrheas, rotavirus, tetanus, whooping cough, which is diphtheria. So there's a multitude of diseases that can be prevented. The schedule is birth, 2 months, 4 months, 6 months, 1 year, 4 years old, and then again when you're about 11 years old. So these are preventable. We all want to keep our children well, and this is very important to be able to do that.
And then are there other things that they have to think about annually?
The flu shot is recommended for any child over 6 months of age. And, of course, the COVID vaccine also. And we don't know what the recommendations will be for next year. But if your child has not had the COVID vaccine series for this year, that is available.
And I guess it's important to ask, are these childhood vaccines safe?
Yes. The vaccine supply is the safest in its history. Millions of children receive multi-millions of vaccines every year. So they're very, very safe.
Well, that's really good to know and good to hear. And so before we end the show, how can we remind parents about how to get their children back on track?
Okay. Again, I'm going to give you the phone numbers again, if that's okay. If you don't know if your child is up to date with vaccines, you can call Lorena Bazzilli at 368-7408. And if you need a record, you can get that at the medical records here. And we also have access to all four states, Utah, Colorado, Arizona, and New Mexico. So if you call into Lorena specifically and say, I might have gotten it here or there, she can compile your vaccines together, which is important. And then you can call 368-6525 to make an appointment. Sometimes you can go in for a quick visit and just have a nurse visit and get an appointment. But I want to say, if your child hasn't seen the pediatrician during this COVID pandemic, it is good to make a well child visit where you can get your immunizations, because it's not just immunizations we want to look at. Pediatricians want to look at your children when they're doing well to make sure they're developing and healthy.
Well, thank you, Alice, for all that information, and thank you for being on the show. This has been Four Directions of Wellness. Hogo Annette.